Masquerade is where we lay this here scene. We're ancient girls breaking new mutants. We're men and men, and women got guns. And things ain't just the way they used to be. Indeed, heck hath no fury like a Gaelic who walk tall and talk tough. She darn to shoot the skin off a lizard at 200 yards with an old-fashioned Texas dirt rifle. What you're about to see here is 100% true. Every word of it. Just the way it happened. Even though I might exaggerate a little bit to make it a little more interesting. My name is Colonel Buffalo Bill Cody, and you can tell him I sent you.
All Western musicals alike. Boy meet girl, but girl too busy with showbiz career. In a time of trouble and prosperity, the real showdown is between man and woman. This is Western musical, so people walk funny. Maybe it's too much jumping on the horse from balcony. People talk funny too, saying things like, I'm sweating like a glass of milk in Death Valley, or I'm sweating like a Tennessee mule in the heat of peanut dry. Thing like that. And as for me, red men talk like this and wear full headdress all the time. It takes me forever to get ready in the morning. But no time to talk. We do show now. This is Cowgirls the Musical. Hit it, Liz.
Okay. get you on the fastest train out of here tomorrow morning if you do me just this one little favor.
You better kill my agent, too. This is my Christmas bonus.
Oh, no. You're about to make a lot of money here, kid.
The lion's share?
The lion's share. Wow. This room is right through there.
This better be good.
The best show in town.
The only show in town.
Your dressing room is right through there.
Just these glossy pictures of the one and only Adelaide Adams.
Who's that?
Why, don't you know who she is? World famous Chicago sensation. I heard all about her.
Hey, Chance, why don't you get to play you next?
What are you interested in her for, Belle?
This means a good entertainment around here.
Hey, Danny.
Danny, what are you doing here? I thought you was gone for good.
Got a few weeks leave from here and you thought I'd come back and see you.
Never heard from you. We got lots to talk about.
Aw, oh, sit down. Show's about to start.
Clammy, how about we take a last walk and show?
I'd love to.
See, I'm turning Miss McKay.
Oh, okay.
Gentlemen, McKay's Old Time Tavern is proud to bring you.
Don't tell us Felix brought her sister again.
I heard that!
This said for you. Now, tonight we have a very special young lady here. All the way from New York City, please welcome Mrs. Frances Farr.
Who's that woman? I know her name.
that's over.
Oh, Miss Adelaide, you were wonderful.
Oh, you're too kind.
No, I mean it. I've learned so much from you these past few months.
Don't be silly. I'm just glad I'm done in Chicago, done in America, and done in show business, and back in Paris where I belong.
What do you mean, done in show business?
Oh, I need a break, Katie, dear. I have a husband and two children who miss me very much. I can't stand to be away any longer.
Well, what about your fans? They love you here. And what about me?
You'll find work.
Easy for you to say, Miss Adelaide. You're a big star. I mean, I can sing, I can dance, and I can do all those things. But it's just so hard for a kid starting out.
Oh, I pray you get out of this business before it eats you alive. I wish I could have gotten out long ago. I paid my dues to be the Adelaide Adams. And it's much harder now. They want younger and younger talent nowadays. What? Maybe you'll be luckier than I was. But it's a dirty business.
Miss Adelaide Adams, are you in there?
If I have to sign one more autograph, I'll scream. I have a car waiting out back. I'll just slip out the back door.
What about all your things? All your beautiful costumes?
Oh, I have no use for them now. You keep them, dear.
Really? Miss Adams!
Oh, Katie. Katie, maybe I wish you the best of luck. And maybe someday I'll see your name in the twinkle of the neon lights. As for me, the stage will always be my home. But my heart belongs somewhere else. So long, Katie dear.
And on top of that, they got Annie Oakley, the best lady markswoman in the world. I heard she's the best shot in the world, period.
I heard she makes Frank Brooke look like a fool.
She's good, I can tell you that. They're a real spectacle, the two of them. Each night they compete in a skeet shooting match that'll knock your socks off.
Skeet shooting? What's that?
You folks are obviously lacking a certain degree of taste and culture. Why, skeet shooting is when somebody says pull, they sling a clay pigeon in the air and somebody shoots at it. Whoever gets the most pigeons wins.
Where'd they get all the pigeons?
Aw, shucks, they're not real pigeons. They're discs about that big made of clay. You shoot it and bam, shatters in a million pieces.
Wow!
What about Miss Adelaide Adams? She'll show us tonight too.
It's a double bill.
We'll have one after the other. You boys can really get your money's worth.
Now what about us?
Yeah, what about us?
This is a gentleman's establishment.
We want to see it too. You boys can have all the fun.
Yeah, we want to see it too.
All right, as long as you're paying full price, I don't care if you see it or not.
Yay!
I like your attitude, Miss McKay.
Look, you go to Clay right now.
Clam!
Quiet, you mangy pack of dirt scratch beetle. Guess who I got under here?
Clam B, it's really hot under this blanket.
It better be Miss Adelaide Adams.
Yay!
Pleasure to meet you, Miss Adams.
Miss Adams, this here's Bill Hickok.
Are you Wild Bill Hickok?
If I am, you can tame me.
Well, now Miss Adams is tired. We better let her rest before the big show tonight.
Come along, Miss Adams. Felix will show you to your dressing room. You clean your dressing room, right, Felix?
Oh, and you should see him, Miss McKay. I set up wrap-ups and everything.
What, Felix?
I did all I could about the insect problem.
Hate it, Felix.
But I guess nobody's perfect.
Felix, get Miss Adelaide something cool to drink and take her to her dressing room.
Yes, ma'am. Oh, and I did clean all the toothpaste off the pan.
Felix!
Right this way.
Well, Calamity, I owe you one.
She's just beautiful as set, Calamity.
What do you care, Danny?
All the time. Getting first class entertainment. Look at her. She's beautiful, she's talented,
and she's way too high class for any of you poor small Nacy. She's a lady, a star. She's got too much class and distinction to have to solo and give you the time of day. So don't get any ideas.
Oh, Calamity, we're just grateful that you brought us such first class entertainment.
Well, let's keep it that way. You boys here listen to Miss McKay, and you're welcome.
Well, Calamity, I don't know what we'd do without you. Now, see here, folks, Buffalo Bill's Wild Whistle will be arriving shortly. Expect to see you all back here at 8 o'clock sharp to see Adelaide Adams, followed by Annie Oakley and Frank Butler, the greatest, smartest people in the world.
Yay!
Stories they never see anymore. The Lord's gonna stand.
we should probably be having technical difficulties or something.
Felix, where is she?
She says she's not coming out.
What?
She says she feels sick and she'll be out as soon as she can.
Aww. Be patient, folks. She's well worth the wait.
All these big city showbiz tops. It's always something. If there ain't one thing, it's another thing.
Are you okay?
Well, I'm just nervous, that's all.
I understand. Why are you dressed up like a woman?
I don't normally dress as a woman. Long story. I guess my ass is really caught on around here. Until you arrived, dude, I was doing Porsche the day in this place. Wow. Money's good. I had no idea.
I just never played in a place like this before.
I know that, Katie.
How'd you know my name?
I went over from Princeton to New York. I remember you from backstage. I'm Frances Pratt, the new crown princess of Butterville.
So I have to get out of here.
Just go out there and do your best. These folks won't know the difference.
Oh, okay.
There she is!
Okay, we're ready. Gentlemen and ladies, McKay's old crown Cameron is proud to bring you the international singing, dancing sensation, the one and only Adelaide Adams.
Break a leg, kid. Wishful thinking. Right here in the tavern?
Can it, Felix? We're about to make a lot of money here.
Yeah,
How do I look, Mr. Bull?
Like a star, honey.
Daisy, listen to that wind kiss.
Right away, Frank. You got your bye, Uncle Sandy, Frank?
I don't worry about Uncle Sandy. My last class, 2020.
Huh? How come you couldn't see that mustard stain on your shirt?
I ain't got a mustard stain on my shirt.
Don't let her intimidate you, Frank.
Yeah, Frank, don't let me intimidate you.
Colonel, can I talk to you for a minute?
Sure, Frank, what is it?
Well, Sandy, she's got a mouth gun.
Part of the act, Frank. Crowd loves her.
But I can't concentrate with her. I was razzing me all the time. I'm supposed to be the best shot in the world.
Yeah, you're pretty good. But Amy's just a little competitive.
She's a menace. I'm thinking I might tear up my contract once we get to Vegas. Set out on my own.
That would be a big mistake. See, since Amy's come on board, ticket sales have gone through the roof. She's a sensation. We've never been more popular.
But I'm supposed to be the star.
Are you ready yet, Frank?
Yeah, I'm ready.
How does this work, Colonel?
Well, since it's your place, I'll have you introduce Charlie, Charlie introduce me, and I'll introduce the show.
So it's basically a line introducing each other.
Basically.
Here's ship, folks. Show's about to continue.
What an amateur.
Folks, we are proud to introduce to you Buffalo Bill's Wild West Show.
No, you introduce Charlie first.
Oh, right. Folks, I'm proud to introduce to you the one and only road manager of Buffalo Bill's Wild West Show, Mr. Charlie
Davenport.
Charlie Davenport.
Thank you, Ms. McKay, for that warm introduction. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I am proud to bring you a picture of the Old West.
We have a picture of the Old West.
With log cabins and covered wagons on the littered countryside.
They still do.
We're selling this front summer on the request for God and New Life.
Oh, get on with
it. All right. I'm presenting you the legendary champion of the Old West, Colonel Buffalo Bill Cody.
Thanks, Charlie. Folks, I have here tonight one of the greatest runners in the world. A magnificent shot, a magical personality, and a great entertainer. Princess of Pistoliers, Miss Annie Oakley! I'm here to challenge her reign as undefeated female marksperson, as formerly undefeated male marksperson, Frank Bullock.
Thanks.
Each night, these two competitors face off in a white-knuckle competition to see who's the best shot in the West. Now, folks, let me remind you that these are professionals. Kids, remember, never shoot off a gun when you're inside the house. Wait till you get outside. Annie, are you ready?
Ready, Colonel.
Frank, ready?
Ready.
And they're off.
Hit pull.
It's a hit.
Amazing. How do you like them apples, Frank?
You want your say?
Pull. It's a hit.
Wow.
And the score stands one even. But you be more on.
Who are you talking to, Colonel?
I'm just thinking out loud. Now figure out saving folks some time. Anyway, the evening wore on. Frank and Annie were toe-to-toe, shooting straighter than the other. Until the saloon was so full of holes, you could see all the way to Tallahassee.
I told you he talks funny.
Let me finish, Chief. Now see, while you folks have been watching the Calamity Jane portion of the show, we've been on the road. Picked up Annie from a small town back when she knew nothing about show business. Then she caught on. She's been giving Frank a run of his money ever since.
Well, Frank, you had enough?
Charlie, where are we?
It's green, Colonel. Frank's up in one shot.
Them lights got in my eyes.
Whatever.
Now, folks, let me remind you that this round may determine who's the best shot. Annie, you ready?
Ready, yeah. But I want Frank to take his first shot.
I'm not ready.
Come on.
No! You're turning. You take it.
I want you to take it. I thought you was the best shot in the world.
That's right.
Then it's all yours.
But...
All right.
Hey!
Yeah.
This scene is in real slow motion.
I ain't never seen you shoot like that.
You
That's nothing.
That plane sure was a handsome devil.
Yeah, when you first walked in, I thought you and him might have been, well, you know.
What?
I thought for sure you had the eyes for him.
For Frank? Nah, he's nothing but a low down
swamp rodent.
Nah, I ain't got the time for that stuff. I'm a professional markswoman. I'm in the public eye. Men and guns just don't mix, let me tell ya.
Charlie, remember the good old days when I was champ and everything was rosy?
Frank, please ain't your girl, please.
I know that. Now pass me the sledgehammer.
Seeing the ice out might be slipping. Never mind, take some time off and come back stronger than ever.
No, Porky fella, see? I should be at the peak of my career. I need some backwards girl making me look like a clown every night. Besides, this gun thing, slow her down. I'll be back on top of it.
Excuse my apologies. Been trying
to roll an eight against mine. I need this break, fellas, or I'm through, you hear me? Through.
What does this get out your feelings, Will?
You guys won't tell nobody, will you?
I don't know if I
you give us 50 bucks, put it right down the middle.
Keep your money. I hope you can live with yourself.
Yeah, well, I'm dirty cheap.
Gee, thanks for all your support. I'm glad I got friends that really understand.
I'm a friend, Frank, but I just don't understand. It just ain't right.
I'm with him. Come on, Charlie. Let's go play poker. I'm feeling lucky.
Don't do it, Frank.
I'll leave me alone. I'll show her.
Bye.
These kids better. So flop to bed now. Past the bedtime. Had a little talk with Charlie. You know, he can be a real weasel sometimes. I once even caught him messing with his eyes, am I right?
Really? He seems so nice.
Nah, he don't like me. Ever since I came out on the road.
Huh.
Yeah, true story.
We just been looking at the moon.
Ain't it beautiful?
Yeah, it sure makes me miss home.
Now ain't that the truth? They say full moon can drive people crazy.
So romantic.
Yeah, I guess.
Maybe Frank, if we didn't have to compete all the time, we might be better friends.
What do you mean, eh?
Well, you seem like a nice guy, and I guess sometimes showbiz makes you mean it for a while.
You might be right. I can leave everything behind for my career. My family, my friends, everything.
You ever been in love, Frank? You ever have to leave a girl behind?
Once, and it wasn't me.
I'll bet.
You ever been in love, eh?
No, I never met the right person, but I heard tell about it.
Thank you.
10-minute intermission. Yeah, turn it on.
It's the moon in your eyes.
What do you know about it?
Oh, nothing. Could it be your falling in love?
What's that mouth of yours, Chief? I'm a professional markswoman.
So just 1 minute more, we may have a new world champion.
Three, two, ready?
Alright.
Alright, folks. This round may determine who's the best shot. Andy, you may take the first shot.
There ain't gonna be another shot, Colonel. I forfeit this match and my championship title as markswoman to Frank Butler.
New world champion markswoman.
Yay! She'll get him.
I guess we can't get the man the gun.
Andy,
I'm Frank. I feel good no more. I should pack up and go home right now.
Don't say that.
No, it's true. You're the real star of this show.
Not anymore, Andy. I can't bear it any longer. You see, I should have won this match. I took the side. You should have won this match. I took the side of guns and fixed them up real good so that they wouldn't shoot straight. I figured I had to do it if I was ever going to be the champ. Feeling terrible about it. Could you ever forgive me?
Well, of course not. You failed to comply with Pine Scum? How did you do this to me after our little song in the moonlight?
Andy, I guess I did it because I realized I kind of liked you.
So, if you like me or something, you shoot me in the kneecaps.
Look, I'll give you back the try, and we won't compete no more. I'll leave the show once we get to Vegas. Sitting out of my office, Pawnee Business Firing Show. You can have the Wild West all to yourself.
But I wouldn't have it. Show that someone to make a fool of every night.
What?
Nobody plays fool better than Frank Butler.
We'll see about that. I'll show you, Andy.
I'm teasing Frank. Listen, you give me back my title, and we're even.
I want us to be together, Andy.
What?
These past 2 weeks have been such a whirlwind. I've never met nobody like you.
How would it ever work, Frank?
We'll be the greatest gunslinging team ever. You and me, from now on. Let's get married, Andy.
Where's my ring?
I'll get one. Then we'll get to Vegas and sign the deal forever.
I don't want a Vegas one.
Well then, how about this?
Yeah.
chill. And now, in the daylight, it's kind of charming. You could fix it up real nice.
How?
Well, a few paint, some paint and a few frills could spruce it up a little. All it needs is a woman's touch.
A woman's touch?
Get a ring around here?
Kind of ring.
Mm-hmm. A diamond ring.
This one from my second one. We threw it at me right before she destroyed my Cadillac. And this one I got from my fourth one. Threw it in the Mississippi along with my keys to my new Buick. I had to swim faster than a pickled herring to get that one. So it's got sentimental value. But I tell you what, I give you both of them for 75. It's grand prices.
I just need one, Colonel.
We still playing poker later tonight, Frank?
No. Sorry, fellas. I'm getting engaged now.
Thank you.
him calm down for a sec.
Anybody else here gets married, I'll rip your lungs out!
What's all that about?
Everybody's happy except me.
I'm chilly!
Y'all go back to your business or I'll carve your hair and leg.
Get me out of this cowboy musical!
Excuse me, Chief, we're in the middle of something here.
Isn't this kind of silly? First, Frank and Annie get engaged after an intermission. Then Katie and Danny, completely out of view. Shouldn't you two think about this first before you tie knots forever?
Chief, Phil and I have given this some thought, and we both think it's time to settle down.
No one wants good advice from real Indian Chief? Fine. Excuse me while I go propose marriage to Ms. McKay and live happily ever after.
Did you think about this first, Chief?
Nah, I better do it now before I change my mind.
Yes, I am.
I can shoot a portrait with
No.
Neither can I.
Yes. You can sing, I can sing sweeter.
I can sing any note sweeter than you.
No, you can.
Yes, I can.
No, you can.
Yes, I can.
No, you can.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Scrappily ever after. Now there's nothing left to do but to walk off in the sunset.